Leo, it's me, Stormy, and here's your 2018 yearly horoscope. So before we jump in, Leo, the birthday appointments are up. If you are new to this channel, this is a once a year gift that I give to you for your sun sign at your birthday time. So click in the description box down below, grab those appointments, grab your spot, because once they're gone, that's it. There's a lot of changes coming for Stormy Grace this year, but I don't want you to miss out on your birthday appointment. So click in the description box and make sure you scoop it up. All right, Leo, so this is going to be a year of hard work, grabbing some things by the balls, taking responsibility for things in your career life, gaining the new skills that you need to take yourself to the next level in your career, which includes not just a career. Maybe you are just gangster at one career that you've had, but you've really been wanting to do something else, or maybe you kicked off and started something else, but now you see the skills you need to be able to learn to maintain it. It's also an abundant year with Saturn in Capricorn here in your sixth house, as well as having Pluto here to be working on these lessons of mastery, of spiritual maturity, of revolution, of structure in this area of your life. Now, this energy really started in December of 2017 when Saturn moved into Capricorn, right? Now, we're going to have this energy here in this area for you for approximately 3 years. So you've got time to work with this Saturn energy. The first 6 months of a Saturn changing of signs is basically a time where Saturn's gonna show you the things that are not working. Now, if you've been working hard in your career, you've been getting your life together, you've been suiting up, showing up, being responsible, this could be a time where Saturn is actually helping you really see the blessings around a major project or something like that. You could be busier than maybe you ever have been before. You could have blessings and a lot of help of people showing up to show you how to move a career decision in some responsibility. If not, Leo, the theme is really going to be taking a whole bunch of responsibility for having the career that you want to be doing in your life, to having correct relationships with co-workers, details, right? This is a very detail-oriented house. It's Virgo energy. So what are the details of running a day-to-day business, having employees, having or having to fire employees? What does that look like? But professionally, you are on track to grow and to learn and to sharpen your skills here in the sixth house. This is also a wonderful place to create some new healthy dynamic structures around your health as well. So make sure, you know, if you're going to put something new in place this year, especially around your health, be as open and as honest as you can about it. Don't hold back with your physician. Don't hold back with your healer. Let them know what's really going on so that they can help you take full advantage of moving this area of your little world forward, okay? Now, another great, exciting news that is a lot less heavy than Saturn energy, Jupiter is in Scorpio. That energy also started in 2017 and will continue throughout 2018 until we get to November. But Jupiter here in Scorpio for you is in the fourth house, bringing abundance to your living space. Jupiter doesn't just want you to expand, though. That's the thing you have to keep in mind. He says, ugh, I want you to expand out. Get out from where you are. Get out. So one of the things we could see happening in your home zone is maybe you're getting a bigger house, right? Jupiter loves to make things bigger, so you could be getting a bigger living space. Now, if you're not getting a bigger living space, what I think happens is that you have the opportunity to be really excited and confident about the living space that you are currently in. It's almost as if you start taking opportunity to really make home home for you. You know what I mean? It feels like your new version of home that fits you, that suits you, that feels like, yeah, this is my dream house, even if it's not the dream house quite yet. Now, what we know is that this definitely signals change in living situation. So you could have somebody moving in, somebody moving out, whatever it is. I think that Jupiter helps to bring not only a sense of enthusiasm, but also some peace to feeling like this is the truth of my home. This is the truth of my housing situation, my domestic life, my relationships with my family, my relationships with women, my foundational level beliefs of who I am and what I have to offer to the world, and you feel really good about it. So if you are looking for a new place to live, Jupiter could really be helping you. You want to use this energy here in Scorpio if you're looking for a new place to live. Now, November 8th, Jupiter is going to move on into a very comfortable energy of Sagittarius. That's the sign that it rules. So this is very, very comfortable. And we're going to start to shift focus from home into love life. Love that for you. Now, this could also be Jupiter's a place of expansion. Maybe somebody's pregnant. Maybe he's having children. You know what I mean? It has a very child feel, and it has the feel of expansion to it as well. But if you are single and you're like, I'm kind of in that place where I'm ready to meet somebody, definitely towards the end of the year, we've got some solid energy for you to work with as well. And if you are in a relationship, I'm telling you, this could be a place where you're thinking about starting a family or starting what you want to be the ideal family situation for you, which what does that look like? Maybe we don't want kids. Maybe we want a greenhouse and we want to nurture and care for plants. Maybe we want to travel. Your ideas of family could be coming together as Jupiter is making this move at the end of the year. Now, we've also got Uranus changing sign this year as well. So from May 15th all the way until November 6th, we just get a little flavor, a little taste of what Uranus in Taurus is going to be like, because Uranus is going to retrograde and move back into Aries until 2019. But in 2019, then that little flavor, that little snippet we've had, we'll be able to see the more permanent version of that with Uranus in Taurus. But from May to November, you kind of get that flavor of Uranus helping you professionally, because this is at the tip top of your chart. This is in the 10th house for you, right? Moves out of Aries in that 9th, moves into Taurus in this 10th. And so you have a place right up here at the top of your chart where professionally you could be rebelling, you could be redoing your career, you could be having a different idea or uncovering things about authority figures. Definitely major changes in your career direction. And what I can tell you, Leo, is you have to get on board. Trust the timing of your life. Trust the heart that you have that says, this is what I want to do. And then also with that Aquarian energy or that Uranian energy, allow people to show up and add value to what you're doing. Allow them to teach you. Stay teachable, stay open, right? You're loving and you're beautiful. Now I just need you to stay open, right? Now, we've also got some other energies that I think are really going to be supportive to you, along with some of this Jupiter energy that we've got going on. There's an eclipse that's going to be happening in your sign January 31st, as well as August 11th. And these are incredibly useful energies for potentially creating a new space, new beginnings, new ideas, things like that. And then we've got some other eclipses that are going to actually be happening in your signs of partnership. So I'm telling you, in terms of partnership, especially in housing and in work, you're going to see some shifts and some brand new beginnings coming along the way for you. By the time we end the year, your career and your home life look way different. Now, let's jump in and break this whole year down by some dates that I've got carved out for you. And don't worry, along the way throughout the year, I'll be meeting with you week by week and month by month, and we will be breaking them down even further, okay? January 31st, we have got a lunar eclipse happening in your sign. Now, this is a total lunar eclipse, so it's important to understand that, because it's a resetting of you, of your emotions, all of these things. And that creates a different kind of energy than a partial. We'll discuss that more this year. But one of the other things to understand is that the 2018 eclipse cycles look a lot like 17 in terms of being in Leo and Aquarian energies, but they're also connected to an eclipse cycle that started in 2016. So I would question you, what were you working on? What were you thinking on? What were you moving towards in 2016? Because it looks a lot more like it's coming to fruition here in 2018. And you look like a person who has grown here in 2018. So look back, think back, and see what those comparisons look like. When we get to the 15th, we have the solar eclipse in Aquarius. So in your opposite, over here in the 7th house, we start to have new beginning of relationships. I'm telling you, it is maybe somebody is getting ready to move into your house, move into your life. You want to commit to something, a new business partnership. Because if you've started anything new in your career, even in this 9th house space, if you've been learning, you've been gathering teachers, you've been getting a YouTube channel ready, you've been preparing to broadcast something new about yourself out there, this is a wonderful, wonderful energy for having those relations come in and have them being solid, but also planting the seeds of intention to, over the next 6 months to a year, usher in new relationships into your life. May 15th, Uranus takes that move into Taurus. We have that sampling of little Tauran flavor all the way until November. Then we're going to experience some more Aries energy. We go back to looking at that 9th house space. And then in 2019, it swings back here forward and we're back into Taurus for several years. June 26th to August 27th, Mars is going to take his retrograde here in the relationship zone for you, so in Aquarius. Now, one of the things with Mars retrograde is it's still a retrograde, so we're going to we're going to re-look at, reconnect, revise, re-edit, re-evaluate, and it's all about actions. It's all about your desires. What are your actions, your desires in relationships? How are you showing up in relationships? How are you not showing up in relationships? And this includes the relationship of you with you, you with other people, especially one-on-one relationships, right? And you maybe even in a business partnership. How are you showing up or how are you not showing up? And sometimes the ways that we don't show up is that we show up and people are like, how are you doing? And we're like, oh, I'm doing fine. Instead of really answering them to say, I'm kind of worried. I'm starting this new thing and I don't really know what I'm doing. You've got to get prepared to offer another level of yourself out there. And I think Mars actually helps to relook at some actions so that you can course correct and bring whatever the new action is into play to help you move some things forward. Now, I always suggest during a Mars retrograde, if you can wait to have elective procedures, all the better. If you don't need to get new chichis today, that would be great. Just wait until after August to be able to do them, because Mars rules over the things that are warlike, and cutting is very much so like war. July 13th, we've got a partial solar eclipse that's actually in Cancer. This is in your 12th house, and I like this here because you have some space here to work on some things behind the scenes. Maybe a project is brewing here. I will tell you that I really do think that at this eclipse, somebody will start an affair that ends up being very, very significant in their life as we finish this year. Not saying I suggest that you do it. I'm just saying that that's definitely a thing that I'm seeing in some of this energy, especially with all this Uranus and Aries. Anyway, or in Taurus. So some of these things that I see going on in this 12th house space is it's just a really nice reset for you as well. Cancer is a very homey, nurturing energy. So you may get to go back into your own home and see how you can continue to create a sanctuary kind of space. But definitely if you are a student, you research, you're trying to complete research, this is a really supportive energy for you. On July 27th, we've got a total lunar eclipse happening in Aquarius, again, 7th house space, so this could be an ending of some relationships where you're like, this doesn't add value, this is not helping me move forward, I'm not showing up appropriately in these relationships, and you get to step up, because it's still the full moon, so it causes us to look at what needs to be ended, acknowledged, and adjusted, so there would definitely be shift and change that can last for 6 months up to a year. On the 11th, we have a partial solar eclipse in your sign again. So new beginnings, Leo, new beginnings. Look from the beginning of the year. Look from 2016, 17, the beginning of this year. What has changed by the time we arrive here in August? How are you looking, right? Are you showing up? Do you have that business out there? Do you have that channel out there? Do you have that book out there? Is your home life ready to go? Are you hosting some parties, bringing some people in, sharing yourself with them? What is the look as we get here in August? October 5th through November 16th, Venus is going to take her retrograde, and this puts a pinch on relationships and finance because it's still a retrograde, so we're still rethinking, reconnecting, re-editing, but she makes it very clear which things have value and which things do not have value, which things have harmony in your life and which things do not, and it's really nice because then you're suited up with some different perspective to move out of this retrograde with and make some really healthy changes. Now, she starts her retrograde here in Scorpio, so in this fourth house, you're re-looking at re-editing that house. If someone's moved in, if you found out you're having a baby, if you got a dog, if you got a chia pet, I mean, whatever, you have to make adjustments, right? You have to make this a space that you value. But then it's going to back up into Libra, and this is going to be you have to communicate. If you need to sign a new lease, right? During a Venus retrograde, I wouldn't suggest that you do it, but you may be looking for a new place to live. You may be looking over contracts. You may be looking at communicating with a sibling. You may be looking at making some decisions about how you feel about relationships or a relationship. All of those things become very much so available and on the table. Now, as we end the year, we're going to end it in that beautiful, comfortable energy I was talking about, where Jupiter is going to move into Sagittarius. He's very, very much so at home. This begins a whole cycle of bringing romance, bringing love, bringing childlike love into your life, whether that be actually having children, adopting, getting pregnant, channeling your inner child, playing from a space of joy, really letting that Leo heart shine forward, taking some different risks, maybe even actually starting a new new business or a new company. Anything that can be seen in the light of conception and risk will fall into this time, and you will meet it with opportunity, with wisdom, and definitely with a lot of enthusiasm. So I look forward to walking through every week and every month of this year with you, guiding you, giving you the very best of how I can show up. So if you've got questions, you can come visit me at stormygrace.com. But don't forget to book your birthday appointment. Click in the description box down below. I'm telling you, when they're gone, they are gone. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. Thank you with all of my heart for spending your time with me. Whether you're old, you've been here for 10,000 years, or you're just showing up today, I'm grateful that you chose to watch this video. I'll see you guys soon.